Look, Maddie, I'm Captain.
Wow, let's take a picture and we'll show it to your parents. Hi, Ellie. How are you? Really? I can't believe that. It's amazing. Yeah, sure. We should go grab a bite soon. With them. Yeah, they're so much fun. I know. Yeah, totally.
Look, Maddie, there's a duck.
Yeah. Okay, you should text me. Okay, I have to go. Bye. Rachel, we should go. Rachel, where are you? It's not funny. Rachel, get out of your hiding spot. Rachel. Oh my God, what did I do? Rachel!
Can you explain again what happened from the moment you last saw her to the moment you realized she was missing?
Well, as I told you, we were in the sand, we were playing, and then I received a call and I answered. I must have turned away, and when I hung up, she wasn't there anymore. And I remember that she was telling me something about a cute dog, or I don't remember. It all happened so fast.
What did you do once you realized she wasn't there?
Well, of course, I looked for her everywhere, screaming her name again and again. And then I didn't find her, so I called the police and kept searching. I called around 15 minutes after she disappeared.
And at what time was that?
It was 12 minutes past 2. I know that because I checked before turning around where Rachel was playing. So that means I called at around 2:30. I'm not sure. I don't know.
Can you describe what she was wearing?
I think that she was wearing a purple dress.
Yes, she was wearing her purple dress, the one with the stripes.
Is it possible that she would follow a stranger with a dog?
Of course, she likes dogs, like all five-year-old kids do. But it's so unlike her to trust a stranger and follow him. I don't know what to think anymore.
Thank you for taking the time to answer our questions.
Don't hesitate to call us if you have any new information.
My little girl, where did my little princess go?
The police are looking for her. We're gonna find Rachel, don't worry.
You know, right now, I would be upstairs with her, watching Frozen, repeating her to brush her teeth, kissing her forehead, touching her nose.
Good Lord, all of this is because of Maddie. My girl disappeared, and it's all the stupid girl's fault. She was supposed to keep an eye on Rachel, and now, she took my treasure away.
You can't accuse her like that. You know she already feels awful.
You don't understand. I'll do everything to ruin this girl's life. Her life should be miserable. She needs to understand our pain.
No, listen. This won't bring back Rachel.
You still don't understand, eh? Mountains. They're kind of far away, but it's totally worth the time.
Yeah. this hiking session, I'm beginning to see a beer belly.
Well, you are getting a little old for these type of activities.
Mind screen.
For sure.
Isn't that Maddie?
What could she possibly be doing this far from town?
I don't know. Maybe we should go talk to her.
No, let her stay alone. Nothing can make up for what she did to us.
Let's not start this conversation again. Let's continue our hike. We have the parking spot until 5 and we just got here.
She's still here. How can she even live with herself? I want to feel as miserable as we do.
If you wanted to make God proud, you would walk away right now and leave this girl alone. We can pass by the church before getting home, but there's nothing more that we can do to bring our girl back to us.
I guess you're right. I'm sorry. It's just, I miss her so much.
I know. Me too.
Are you up for steak and fries?
Yeah, as long as you don't burn the house down.
Just watch me.
Oh, look, they're saying here that the new Harry Potter attraction park in California just opened. We should totally go one day.
You're such a kid.
Wait, what is this? Look, it's about Maddie.
Her again? Are you kidding me?
Just read the article, John.
This girl, she's responsible for the kidnapping of Rachel and now she kills her own boyfriend? I kept telling you that she was demented and crazy, yet you kept defending her because you thought she was normal.
John, you're missing something. They're saying that the crime has been committed yesterday between 1 and 4 p.m. At what time did we see Maddie yesterday?
I'm not sure. I think we parked at around 1:30. But it doesn't matter. She could have surely done it afterwards.
The autopsy doesn't lie, John. They know that the crime has been committed between these hours. We saw Maddie with our own eyes after 4 p.m. And we were about 1 hour away from the city. There's no way she could have killed that man yesterday.
Well, even if she did not commit this crime, what could we possibly do about it?
We could be the witnesses that she needs. We know the exact time and place that she was. If we don't say anything, she's going to live a miserable life in prison. Why would you wish that to someone?
You know who I would wish that for? I would wish that for the person that's responsible for our daughter's kidnapping.
Maddie Howard, a 29-year-old woman, was convicted of first-degree murder for killing her boyfriend, Henry Dixon. The two individuals were having a long-term relationship. The unexpected turn of events and a lack of an alibi on Ms. Howard's side of the case led her to a lifelong sentence at the Fox River Prison.
Forgive me, God, for I have sinned.